I had to say, the Barrington River, Nova Scotia, where we're sitting here today, you're not going to find a more interesting, dangerous, and also beautiful river than this here. I mean, it's got it all. It's awesome. My family's been doing log drives on this for 5 generations, if you count myself. Well, I guess you can't now. So, I had my Uncle Stanley on the river today. He's 72 years old, and he's loving it. He's the river boss, and he's the greatest pleasure to have with me out there because he's got the most experience. He actually did the log drives right till 67 and even 83. I have my cousin Raymond and Renee, the two twins, and they were a lot of help too because they've been on the last log drive that we had here when I was only a boy. I was 6 years old when I was helping them. And Uncle Stanley would make sure that everyone is off and free, and when that last one's gone, he'd jump on the tail end and ride it down through the rapids, so he was the king. He tells me to take every precaution there is, but he doesn't tell me not to do it. You know, he's pumped, he's living it. Same as, well, my mom, I mean, she's like, Darren, I'm just glad that you're out there doing what you love to do, you know? Chrissy's Falls has S churn at the top, and so when you're going down, you can't go too far left, but you gotta swing around. And so what happened is the log got twisted and hung up on the biggest rock with the biggest drop right behind us. And where it was a raft, it kind of sunk the bottom log under and pinned it against those rocks. And so I tried bobbing on the end of that log hanging out over the current, but it wasn't budging. So we knew we had to give a rope. And so I threw a line over to Uncle Stanley, or I guess he threw one over to me. And we tied a timber hitch around the end, and we were pulling from the other side, and the rope goes ping in the air, and oh no, there's a chance, and then the log swung around, and they're all yelling at me, jump, Darren, jump, now is your time, you gotta go, and I was just waiting to catch the tail end. Oh, it was so awesome.
This is your life. Oh. This is your life. Are you who you wanna be? This is your life. Is everything you dreamed it would be when the world was younger and you had everything to lose?
I train exclusively because the sport is in my blood. I mean, I have to. I love it. Like, it's like these guys, I mean, they're out there and they're getting the rush from it too, because that's all we love. Like, and some people would say, oh, that's crazy, what are you playing in the brook for? What are you going? They can't understand, but once you get the rush, I mean, and from this, you won't go back. And so it's in the family. I knew it was coming. I was watching that rock the whole time, and I just tried to ride up over that, and they were spinning too, you know, and I tried to hold on to it and fell off, and luckily I was off the back end so that, you know, I didn't get crushed. And but that was too tricky. I mean, you're getting catapulted off the back end. Anyway, I watched my ride float away. I was kind of bummed.
Don't close your eyes.
Come up and try to see if I could surf that wave, but my canoe has got low gunnels and not much of a rocker to it, so the nose end caught the water and flipped back up, so, well, that swamped her.
Don't close your eyes.
Sinking. Oh, I didn't think it'd go. Usually you can ride the gunnels of a canoe even though it's under, but I was shocked. It kept going deeper and deeper, and so I had to swim down to the bottom, pull it up. And the freaking Arctic cold waters like we have here in May in Nova Scotia.
Don't close your eyes.
Training the way I am, it means everything to me, because when I stand in the block or strap into the pole to do my race, I mean, it helps just to know that I am who I am, you know, and this is where I come from. What a day, eh?